front beak or the high level mudguard on the Triumph Tiger 800. I've got mine and it didn't come with a beak, and the beak completes the look of the bike. So there you go, there's the beak. It's basically, let's get that camera up, that's it. There's the beak. It comes with the plastic thing underneath that you used to mount it with. Comes with a few screws and brackets to hold it on. And it just comes with a bit of paper. That's all it comes with. But, and obviously it comes in the Triumph box, so that there is what you get when you order it. We can go online, and if you go online you can order, not order, but you can download the fitting instructions for it. There's my bike with no beak on. Just got the lower mudguard, and we'll come back as we're progressing and crack on with it. So as far as I'm aware, there's a couple of bolts that has to come out, which is one there and one on the other side. Could do with a bit more light putting on this side, but you get my drift. Looking from the front of the bike, this nut here, which is an Allen key, and then on the other side you've got one exactly the same, which is there. Hopefully they're the ones anyway. And then coming around to the top of the bike, you have one here and one here that has to come off. So, 10mm, preferably a ring spanner, that'll help you get that one out. So it's a little bit on the tricky side, but then now I'm going to come down and get that one there, which is in there anyway. So I'll take that one out. Right, them two bolts are out now, either side. Now coming on to looking at the tank, we've got two bolts, that one and then this one, so they've got to come out. So there you go, just these two bolts, that one and that one, and then we'll come back once that's done. Right, I've taken the bolts out either side. Okay, so there's nothing in it, and the whole thing now, which should slide forward. There you go, out it comes. So I'll just put this over here for now, and that's the front beak that's come off. There's the screws, the two very front ones with the bolts on, and these are just Allen key ones. So front beak, let's see what I've got to do now. And that looks man, does that look weird without it. But anyway, okay, next step, we've got a couple of screws that we have to undo once we've got the beak off, and those screws are down. You're looking at the beak, okay, it's just a little bit dark in here. If you look down there, right, you've got a screw, and then up here you've got a screw. These two have to come out. Okay, I've done it on this side. Take them screws out. Slightly awkward, can't even do it. But I'll come back in a minute and show you that. But as I say, it's those two screws. But you've took the screws out, you've separated everything, and you've separated the beak. Okay, So, after you've done that, you've got your beak and your beak support. Okay, so you replace the beak support that's come with the triumph part. Okay, and then you put aside the beak that was on it. Okay, so then what we do is we come back here and we put the screws back in. Okay, tighten that up. So it's looks exactly the same as it did before, except without the beak that was on the bike. So I'm just going to do that. Okay, well I've done one side screwed in. Okay, so I'm just going to do the other side. And all you do is slot it back as it was before, like so. Line it up. Get one screw in. Okay. To line it up properly. If I don't. And there's the last screw that goes in. Just remember, it's plastic, so there's no need to over tighten them. Anything like this, you just do it. So it just bikes. So there you go. That now is, instead of the beak that comes with the triumph, before you take it off and separate it. That's how it looks now. So, and now what I've got to do is I'm going to put these lugs, these mounting lugs, on here. So the beak can fix on. Once you've got your beak, you've got these which are covered. Okay, so you need to take them off. Just peel them off. So you've got your holes there now. And now you can fix that. Alright, okay. You put the beak support in, turn it all upside down, and then what you'll do is you'll use wherever they are, your four screws that come in your little triumph pouch, and then you'll screw them down into these holes. Okay, so just to give support and strength. Okay, so I've screwed them in. Okay, not too tight, just nice and hand tight. And now what we've got is we've got these lugs, strappings or whatever they're called, and you have to put one on each at the front. Okay, that way you can see, but I'll put one on that one. Just make sure you slide them on the right way around with that lip going to the back. Okay, so that's clipped. Okay, that's how it should be. Same on that side, both done. Now we can see about getting the mudguard on. Let's see how, where we're going here. So, that's one. There you go. And just get these brackets in. Right. I've got that up, pushed it all back, so all it needs now is the screws putting back in. I'll just get on with that. Okay, the last thing to do is put the nut and bolts back, and obviously it's there now, it's looking better, but I've just got to put these bolts in just to complete it and tidy it up. It's the first instructional that I've done, and it's the first time I've ever done anything with the Triumph mudguard, but it actually does make the bike, it finishes it off. So let's have a look now. There you go, finished once these bolts are back in, and very nice. So there you go, guys. that is how you install the Beak or the high level mudguard on Triumph Tiger 800. Hope that helped you out if that's what you're looking for, and see you later.